Marla Barnes, publisher of the Hydro Group for Penwell, and here is this week's Hydro Headlines. Swiss hydropower producer Ofima SA has finished the installation of one of the world's largest double horizontal Pelton turbines in their Bavona hydropower plant. The turbines have been delivered by Norwegian's Rainpower and have a capacity of 41 megawatts each. Rainpower's contract with Ofima also includes delivery of a second turbine, which will be put into operation in 2011. Rainpower's total contract with Ofima has a value of more than $34 million. The plant's output will be increased by about 30 megawatts when both units are put into operation. The U.S. Supreme Court has asked the Obama administration for an opinion on whether the Montana Supreme Court ruled correctly when it determined that PPL Montana must pay rent for the company's use of riverbeds beneath its dams. In August, PPL Montana asked the Supreme Court to overrule a Montana Supreme Court decision from last March that ordered the company to pay $40 million in current rent, as well as past rent and other fees. In the UK, the Wavehub Marine Energy Project has been plugged into the national grid for the first time as part of tests to convert wave power into electricity. A 12-ton wave hub socket has been installed on the seabed 10 miles off the Cornish coast, with cables linking it to a new electricity substation. Wavehub is creating the world's largest test site for wave energy technology by building a grid-connected socket on the seabed off the coast of Cornwall, England, to which wave power devices can be connected and their performance evaluated. The $64.3 million project has been developed by the Southwest Regional Development Agency and is a cornerstone of its strategy to develop a world-class marine energy industry in Southwest England. Alstom has inaugurated its new hydropower manufacturing facility in China. The new site will, over time, fully replace Alstom's original factory in the country. The manufacturing facility is being constructed in two main phases, with phase one already operational. To ensure gradual transition of the workload, Alstom's existing factory in China will remain operational until the second phase has been fully completed. Representing an investment of $156.5 million, the new facility is Alstom's first carbon-neutral manufacturing site in China. The new facility will have a total area of nearly 250,000 square meters and a production capacity that is 20% greater than the old site, capable of delivering up to 30 turbine and generator units per year, with outputs ranging from 20 megawatts to 1,000 megawatts. Just a reminder, the Hydrovision International Conference organizers have extended the call for abstracts deadline. You now have until this Friday, November 12th, to submit your ideas. To submit, go to www.hydroevent.com and click on the Conference tab. Well, that's the Hydro News for this week. Please watch for this newscast each Tuesday, brought to you by Hydro Consulting and Maintenance Services.